welcome to Throwback Thursday on Supercars of London. And today we're going to get into the Christmas spirit and throwback to a couple of shopping videos that I've had in this car when I first bought it, and also when I got my exhaust system, how I deafened my microphone and my camera. I don't think it's ever been the same since. We're also going to be throwing back to the shopping videos to talk about my up and coming Christmas special video on Supercars of London, when I do a bit of Christmas shopping myself. But we're also going to look at how nervous I was when I was taking my car, the width of it, and how worried I was about curbing the wheels. And then when I went back with the Army Trix and the Project wheels as well, how nervous I was there. And I'll probably talk about how much of a joke it was, how much shopping I bought, and how I didn't actually leave the shopping in the shopping centre, and I actually fitted it well within the boot space that I had on the car. Right now I'm headed to the haunted old people's home, so check out some of the best clips from when I went shopping in the Audi R8.
I feel like I'm on my driving test again. At least the car in front didn't stall and roll back into me. That's a plus. Sweaty palms. Sweaty palms. Oh my god, here we go. I'll slow down. I may have to do this in a three-point turn. Oh my god. I'm an idiot for doing this. I don't think I curbed them. Not too bad. Not too bad. I'll probably get one, two, so that the girlfriend's bags fit. Supercar boot space. I'm ripping my own. Looks like that's what's only gonna fit in. Looks like only my stuff's going home with me tonight. Living with a supercar. The boot isn't great. How does that from the warm into the cold, back at the old people's home to talk to you about the videos that you've just watched, or the clips that you've just watched, talking about going shopping in the Audi R8 for living with a supercar. I actually haven't been shopping or up into the shopping centre in this colour, so maybe I should do that as maybe a Christmas video. But the first thing that I want to talk to you about is the Christmas special that is going to be coming. I try and fit a Christmas tree somewhere into this car. So that Living With A Supercar episode is going to be happening on the 20th of December and is the Saturday before Christmas. But let's kick off to begin with the first time that I went shopping, when the car was completely stock, I decided to go shopping and show you guys what the boot space is like in this car. So I went, got some presents for my girlfriend, and also bought myself something from Zara, which came in that awkward box. And I made out that it didn't fit in the car. Now, I don't know whether it was my good acting skills or whether I actually came across as stupid as I looked, of not putting the box in the right shape. But I thought that it would be funny to prove that maybe there's some boxes that don't fit in the Audi R8. And I got a lot of hate for it, which when I look back at the comments, I think it's quite funny, because really, of course you could have fitted that box in, and I could have taken all of my shopping home, but I thought the irony of not fitting my gift to myself in the car, but being able to fit all of my girlfriend's stuff in, to completely swap it around and just put my stuff in and leave my girlfriend's shopping behind. However, it all came home with me, so not to worry about that one. But I think that was probably the first video where I got some real negativity about me owning the car, which came as a shock. I wasn't expecting it to come from that video, but oh well. Where are my keys? And I'll actually show you what I've got in the boot of my car right now. This is like MTV Cribs. Nothing. All I have is a family pack. Oh, a family pack high visibility vests. There, there. And I've also got some Parata della Strada stickers in my car as well. And you may ask, why am I wearing, what have I got this in my car? This was from Gumball 3000. You get a huge fine if you don't have the necessities that France requests off UK drivers. So we had to spend, I think it was around £40 to £50 on high vis, on a triangle, on what else did you have to buy? Breathalyzer and things like that. It was a complete waste of time because I never used it. But I mean, if you did get pulled over, they will fine you for every individual item you don't have. So it was something that everyone on the Gumball 3000 had to buy. So you've now had a tour of the inside of my car, inside the boot space. Let's move on to the second time that I went shopping. I got a lot of requests to go back into the car park when I had my Armytrux exhaust system fitted. But I also had the Projects Design wheels, which there was a lot more at stake when it came to curbing my wheels, and it was also a lot louder and would deafen a few people. So I took my GoPro and I also took this video camera. And when I came out of the car park and I'd finished shopping, I was listening to the quality on my video camera and realized that the exhaust system on my car had actually damaged the microphone inside, which is here. So, annoyingly, the 125 decibel Armytrux exhaust system is too loud to film in enclosed spaces like the car park. There wasn't that much shopping that got done, and I actually just went and got my hair cut, and even that messed up. So regardless of whether I had planned to mess up the video or not, it always gets messed up. This throwback was quite a quick decision to make on what I was going to do. The whole shopping videos were hilarious to do. Maybe I'm going to do another one on top of the Christmas tree. I'm not entirely too sure yet, but they were a lot of fun to film, and it was incredible to hear my exhaust system in the enclosed space. But also, the tight spaces from moving from floor to floor is something that this car can't cope with very well. The four-wheel drive, the heavy steering, and the wheels are all at risk, and it's really difficult to actually maneuver around in a car park like that. I'm just gonna turn my phone off because it's annoying me. It's buzzing all the time. There we go. The last thing that I want to talk to you about on this video is the next Supercars of London competition. I did say when we had hit 100,000 subscribers, there was going to be competition after competition. The winner Ferrari has finished. It ended on Monday. Unfortunately, I don't know who or how the winner is going to be announced. That's not something that I'm in control of. However, the next competition is going to be happening on my Twitter account. So make sure that you're following at WallacePJW, because this is going to be a retweet competition where I'm going to be posting a tweet, and anyone that retweets it is going to be in the chance of winning the prize. And the prize for this competition is going to be driving three supercars and having a passenger ride piloted by a racing driver in another supercar. So this is off the back of the Virgin Experience days that I had when I drove the Ferrari 458 Italia and Lamborghini Murcielago LP640. They've been kind enough to offer this prize, and it's going to be happening on Twitter tomorrow. I'm going to be tweeting at 7 p.m. tomorrow, Friday, where you can retweet it and be in with the chance of winning this competition. And I'm also trying to organize it so that the winner and myself are going to be down there on the same day driving the supercars, so that we can make a fantastic video for YouTube. So definitely head over to Twitter, follow me, and look out for the tweet that's going to be happening tomorrow at 7 p.m. And that's the last of the announcements. Like I said in the previous video and the previous video and the previous video, blah 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 blah, the videos are coming thick and fast in December. I'm really excited to push out so many videos about getting the Christmas tree in this car. I'm also planning on pulling a prank on SB Race Engineering as a bit of a Christmas special as well. And there's lots more to come, including this competition. So thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this Throwback Thursday. Let me know whether you want to see another shopping video and ask me different items to buy in the shops, and then try and see if I can fit them in this car. Top Gear do it all the time, buying each other awkward presents and trying to fit them in the car. So why not? Let's give this a go on my car as well, but just make sure it doesn't damage the car. So get your suggestions down in the comment box on what you think I should buy in the shops and try and fit in my car. Maybe that is the next shopping video with the baby blue R8. Thanks for watching. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow when I'm planning on pranking SB Race Engineering. They don't know it, and they also don't watch my videos, so they're not gonna be expecting it. And then Saturday, living with a supercar, how much fun can you have in the Audi R8? Thanks for watching. Cheers, guys.